We can do this every day. When we are separated right now, I want to ask you to do a couple of things. One of them is, I want you to make sure that you read your Bible every day, okay? And I think it's better to do it with a Bible like this, if you have one at home, and I think you all do. Instead of doing it on a screen when you're doing Zoom and then you're doing a screen, it's better to just put the screen away and just read a Bible like this. But if you have to do it on a phone or on a tablet or something, that's last priority. But first priority would be to get one of these. So God opens the eyes of the blind. Jesus did that when he was here, walking around in a body like us before he died on the cross and before he went back to be with the Father. It says the Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. Now, I think about that puppy that was bowed down. That means when you're sad. The Lord is the one that can lift you up. You know, we sang, bless the Lord, O my soul. In some other psalms, the song says it's a way of singing to your own soul. And one of a couple of the psalms that I think go together say, O my soul, why are you cast down within me? We looked at that maybe a month or so ago. And it says, hope in the Lord, I will again praise him. And so God is the one who is able to lift us up if we are bowed down, like a puppy dog where his tail droops and he feels sad. If we feel sad like that, we can turn to the Lord, and he's the one who lifts us up. And the Lord loves the righteous. Boys and girls, another thing I want to ask you to do is this. I want to ask you, reading the Bible every day, to pray. And if you have family Bible time or devotions, then I want you to talk with your parents or your grandparents, and I want you to tell them what you're thinking about all of this, because they might not know everything that you're thinking. And so then we can, at our homes and where we are, or with your brothers and sisters, we can pray for each other. And we can ask God to encourage us and lift us up. And also, God wants us to remember to do what we should do. Now, here's the thing. The Lord watches over the sojourners. I'm going to flip over to another passage. So if you want to go with me there, it's at the end of John chapter 13. The Lord watches over the sojourners. Now, Peter the apostle, when he was writing to a group of Christians, he said that we all who are Christians, we are sojourners in this world. We are aliens and strangers living in a place where we are people that our nation, our place where we belong is with God and with his kingdom. And so while we are in this world, we are sojourners. God watches over us when we're going through this. The disciples that were with Jesus didn't understand this completely. And the big thing that they didn't understand was that Jesus would have to go away and they would be alone and he wouldn't be with them for a while. Now, where was he going? He was going to the cross, and then after the cross, he was going back to be with the Father. And he told them this right before he went to the cross. Now, you know that in the Bible, in the Gospels, Peter thought that he had a better plan, and the other disciples didn't get it either. Peter went to Jesus one time, and he said, Jesus actually asked him a question first, and he said, who do people say that I am? And then he said, who do you say that I am? And whenever Peter answered for the disciples, he said, you are the Christ. That means you're the one that God sent to be our King and our Savior and to rule forever. And so Peter got that right. And Jesus said, people didn't reveal this to you. God helped you see this. God opened the eyes of your heart, Peter, so that you could understand this. Now, in the Gospel of John, Jesus had changed and he was going away from talking to people in public and the temple and all those things. And he was getting ready for the last night when he was going to be with his disciples. And then he was going to go to the cross the next day. He was going to die for our sins. And this is what he said. When Judas ran away and was going to betray him, Jesus said to his disciples, he said, now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him at once. And glorify him at once. That's a lot of glory. That's a lot of glorifying. Here's the thing. God's plan is to glorify himself, and that is good for us. But we don't always understand it. Listen to what Jesus says next. Little children, yet a little while I am with you. Jesus called them little children because he loved them, and he was the one that cared for them and taught them. He said, you will seek me, just as I said to the Jews, so now I say also to you, where I am going, you cannot come. And then he said, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another, just as I have loved you, so you also must love one another. By this, all people will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. Now, we don't understand God's plan all the time. This is a time when things are very different. We read about things that happened in the past that were dangerous and viruses that happened, but now we're having one that's in the whole world. And so we don't really understand God's plan, but God does. And God has a good plan and a good purpose for all of it. What we know is what he told us. He told us that he wants us to keep loving God. He wants us to keep loving each other. And so we should love God, we should love other believers, and we should love our neighbors. So that's a third thing I want to ask you to do. The first thing is I want you to read your Bible every day. I want you to be praying every day and talking with your family about what you're thinking, praying about those things, and I want you to find ways to love other Christians, other believers, and to love your neighbors, okay? You're not supposed to be within 6 feet of them, and we're supposed to be in our houses, so you're going to have to be creative, okay? Now, Peter still didn't get it, and Peter asked a question. Simon Peter said to Jesus, Lord, where are you going? Jesus answered him, where I am going, you cannot follow me now, but you will follow afterward. Peter said to him, Lord, why can I not follow you now? I will lay down my life for you. Jesus answered him, will you lay down your life for me? Truly, truly, I say to you, the rooster will not crow until you have denied me 3 times. Now, here's the problem that Peter got into, and I want us to avoid this. Peter thought he had a better plan. Peter, back whenever Jesus said, who do you say that I am? And Peter said, you're the Christ. Peter said, that's good, and this is who you are. But then Jesus said, I'm going to go die on a cross. And when Jesus said that to the disciples, Peter said, no way. And you know what Jesus said to Peter? Peter was standing there and he said, no way. And Jesus said, get behind me, Satan. That's what, after Peter said the thing that God revealed to him, Jesus said to Peter, whenever Peter said, I have a better plan, I don't want you to go to the cross, well, they didn't understand it. And so Jesus said to Peter, get behind me, Satan, because he had in his mind, the things that were not God's plans, and he wanted to actually stop God's plan. That's always a bad thing to do. Peter thought he knew better, and then that night, when Peter said that he would lay down his life for Jesus, what happened was they came to arrest Jesus, and Peter pulled out his sword, and Peter sliced off the ear of the one guard, which means that either Peter was really good with a sword or he was really bad with a sword. And so then they took Jesus away. Someone's laughing. There's no one here, but one person is laughing. Peter didn't understand, and it took him a while, but Jesus knew exactly what was going to happen. Peter was afraid, and he didn't know what to do whenever he went into the courtyard. And when he went into the courtyard, then they started asking him, aren't you one of his disciples? And Peter said, no, 3 times. He denied him 3 times. And when that happened, then the rooster crowed. And Peter went out crying because he realized that he said that he was going to be brave for Jesus, and then he betrayed him, just like Jesus said. But Jesus had a plan. Jesus knew that Peter, even before it happened, Jesus knew that Peter would deny Jesus. And guess what? Even though Peter would fail, and Jesus knew that Peter would fail, that he wasn't going to be perfect during that time when he didn't understand all those things. Jesus had a plan for getting Peter through it and then restoring him, and then having Peter have a job to do in Jesus' kingdom and in the work that he had for Peter. So Jesus met Peter by the sea, and he walked with him, and he asked him, just like Peter denied him three times by a charcoal fire in the courtyard when Jesus was on trial, Jesus talked to Peter by a charcoal fire on a beach at the Sea of Galilee. And when they walked along, Jesus asked Peter three times, Peter, do you love me? And three times Peter said, yes, I do. And we can read about that at the end. But he said, yes, I do. And you know that I do. You know everything. And then he said to him, I want you to feed my sheep. I want you to care for my people, my lambs. And so he gave Peter a job to do. Now, boys and girls, that's an amazing thing. Because sometimes we think that when we go through a time that is confusing and scary, or we don't know what's going to happen, and then when we get through it, we realize we didn't behave the way we should, that we let God down, that maybe God is angry with us and he doesn't have a job for us to do anymore, or we're not supposed to be a part of his plan. That's not true, because his grace is huge. And what he does is he brings us back to himself through that. I want to ask you to do this. We're supposed to love one another. I especially want you to do this. I want you to focus on listening well to your parents and your grandparents. And I want you to think about how God wants you to listen really well to them and obey them. Because going through this will be much better, because we're all in our houses right now. We're kind of closed in. God wants you to turn to him and rely on him with the Bible and with prayer. God wants you to be loving everyone around you, including annoying brothers and sisters. And God wants you to obey and honor and listen to what your parents are saying, or your grandparents. And by doing that, we can go through this time where we know what he wants us to do and do those things, even when we don't know all the things that are happening or what God's plans are for all of these things. So in about 16 minutes after we finish chapel, we are going to do another meeting live stream where we're going to do an interaction where you can ask me questions about what you're thinking, about these things, about anything. And it can even be theological questions like middle schoolers have and Mrs. Niederman's class, and we'll be able to chat through Facebook Live. But first, there might be a special guest again this week, so let's, where we are, bow our heads and pray, and you can keep one eye open for the special guest if you want. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word, and we thank you for Jesus, and we thank you that you have a plan, and I ask that you would help all of us to not trust in anything without trusting in you first, especially our own understanding, but that in all of our ways we would acknowledge you, that we would trust you, and we would turn away from evil. Father, we ask that your grace would help us to do this while we are in our homes and we are working on Zoom with our classes and we are doing different things. We thank you for the beautiful weather today, and we thank you for the opportunity to do this live stream of chapel. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Perry, big round of applause, and his wonderful dancing abilities. Thank you, Harry. Thank you very much, boys and girls, for joining us. Before you go, a few things I want to tell you about. First of all, today for our Spirit Week, you were asked to dress in your chapel best. So I'm hoping that at some point your parents will be able to get some pictures of